Today I'm going to talk about what we see on screen that data driven innovation. I think that a lot of people, we are here because everyone's excited about data. You hardly you can go around and not hear words like data analytics, data security, data intelligence, control and you press every day. I think that's part true because of the vast volume of data that's being generated every day, and also because different companies are starting to use data analytics. You've heard about banks using data to detect fraud in their systems. You've heard about schools using data to help develop more targeted intervention programs to help their students learn better to excel in the world, right? But to me, actually, I'm not so excited about data. I'm actually more excited about innovation and data, which is why I'm not over there in human innovation. It's innovation that excites the company or Google in Google's case, and what we want to see in more innovation. I'm going to talk first about this example of a city council. Now this example comes from New York. We all know that when you throw oil, fats, and stuff down the sewage pipes, they get clogged, right? Because as they pull, they coagulate, and then you have a crack fill. And suddenly, and you know in New York, where I think a lot of cracks mix, gets to extract it out into the streets. New York was fighting this problem for big time, some years ago. And of course, the coverage thing about it would be restaurants, right? Fried food and instead of fried food. Dispose of the oil and dirt consumer, might be easy just to dump it down the drain. The easy way out would be to send inspectors down to every restaurant in New York City and do spot check to see whether they throw and they dispose of the waste oil and dirt consumer. Now that's possible, but it's also not very scalable, right? How many inspectors do you need to hire and send out every day to make sure? So New York City actually did a different approach. They used the data driven innovation, right? It turns out that in New York City, they actually keep a ledger of which restaurants are actually using which so-called waste oil dredges or haulers. And what they did was they had a map of all the restaurants in New York with a geospatial approach. And they overlaid that with the information they had which restaurants were using the haulers for their waste oil. And so for that, they were able to narrow down quite quickly which ones were potentially throwing oil or using unlicensed waste oil haulers. So that's quite easy, and I think that's they achieved 95% success rates in Japan. So the reason why I raised this example is actually, you know, data analytics is actually not, I mean, there are many skills with it, but it can be very simple, right? If you think about how you can use data in very simple ways, you actually can generate a lot of data. Now, in this example, I'm going to show you this. Farmers can do it as well. I'm not sure how many of you here are from New Zealand, and I'm not sure that this is a true phrase, but I've been told that what the difference between a successful farmer and a non-successful okay, what does that mean? Actually, that means that the more experienced farmers actually know when to start cutting the grass to get it for oil, to get it for feed, for farm animals later, and then they start to get the cows, for instance. So all this is based on judgment, right? But what happened is that this company is pretty smart. They actually know what they learned about this platform. They work with farmers. Right? Farmers just have to decide when to start cutting. And you can show you things like when do they start selling the food, right? What's the price like, what's the weather like, and it's really a great complex farmers, right? You're really busy dealing with logistics to think about, you still think about the commercial side of things. So what this platform does is it takes a lot of the judgment work out for your farmers. What it does is it to input what you have and then from the animals they have, the vehicles they have. And then the platform also bring information. And from there, they make some projections, right? When should they start cutting the grass? When should they start the grass? What was interesting for me, about what I can see from here, is that people using the this platform, actually 10%, 17% higher average gross margin per hectare compared to farmers who are not using this platform. Now, this is the average, obviously, they're really farmers who show that they, some of them are unique to perform at a higher profit margin. But it, to me, this means a few things, right? I mean, even farmers can benefit from their innovations. Again, how do you enable them to in this case, it's an enterprising company. But you think about that people, right? How realistic would it be? It would be that, look, if the number of data is on banking, so how much price per kilogram makes solid sense, it's very hard for the company to then be able to put in information and inform the farmers at scale what's happening. Okay. Now, we do sweat examples in data. Actually, we do sweat examples with this. I just talked about three data sets, right? But think about that. The world is always being full of data, full of facts, right? Some of it are making themselves, some of it is based on potential generating potential content. But like sand, right? I can compare like data is okay with this, it's a renewable and unreliable source. You can't argue with facts, right? But what's interesting about it is not the facts that are important, but the innovation that you can find out of the facts that's important. You think about what sand is to certain, I would say what the data is for innovation. Your data is not going to much, it's going to be information things. And you can use it in many ways. The last example, before I go there, right? You think about data reviews, so something new. Can someone tell me, okay, I'm not sure whether I can solve, but can someone tell me what's one of the oldest form of data reviews?
Even if you're